Are you thinking about getting a 3D printer or another one for your shop? I think I just found the best deal on an Ender 3 Pro or an Ender 3. I'll explain it all on today's Film of Friday. Film of Friday is brought to you every week by the generous donations of these Patreon supporters. This video is also brought to you by PCBWay.com, a great place to get low-cost circuit boards and also low-cost assembly services, all from one place. PCBWay.com. So what makes this a better value printer? It's because this is actually an Ender 3 Pro X from Banggood.com, and the X means extras. It gives you two extras. One, a silent driver board already installed in the machine. It's an 8-bit board to version 1.1.5, but it's got the TMC driver, so this thing is really, really quiet. In addition to that, they give you a glass bed. On top of the bed that's here, the magnetic bed, so you have two different bed services. This alone is a $20 addition, and the board itself, if you can get a hold of one of these, is about $35. So it's $55 of material you're getting for only $20 more than a standard Ender 3. The current Ender 3 and Ender 3 Pro come with a 32-bit board, so some may say, isn't 32-bit better than 8-bit? Well, it is and it isn't. It depends on the firmware. If you have a 32-bit processor, but you put crappy firmware on it, it's not any better. In fact, the firmware that's on these 8-bit boards is so solid. This is version 1.1.8 on here, which is a very solid version of Marlin. The version that Creality includes on their 32-bit Ender 3 and Ender 3 Pro are missing a lot of features. That's why if you have a brand new Ender 3, and you try to run my bed level where it stops at each adjustment nut so you can level your bed, I get reports of people saying it doesn't stop, it just keeps going. It's because their firmware doesn't recognize the M0 command. I've had other people say I've tried to use Prusa Slicer with their different levels to print multiple colors. Well, that requires an M600 command, and a lot of the Ender 3, Ender 3 Pro 32-bit firmware don't recognize that. So right out of the box, you got to reflash your firmware on your 32-bit machine, which isn't a big deal, but if you're new to 3D printing, that can be a big deal. And all those features are perfect on this 8-bit board. And the fact that it's got silent drivers is a big bonus to me, because those 32-bit boards that come on the Ender 3 and Ender 3 Pro do not have silent drivers. So they are really, really noisy. When this thing is moving, the steppers are churning, it's loud. This silent driver, incredibly quiet. Now if you're looking for an Ender 3 with 32-bit and silent drivers and a glass bed, well that's where the Ender 3 V2 comes in. But you're gonna pay $269 to $279 for that guy. I'm talking low value here. I mean, this right here, the Ender 3 Pro X, is $216 at Banggood.com. And they got some sale going on the next couple days, so you might find a sale. But if you use the links in the description below, it does help the channel. It's an affiliate link. But if you're really on a budget, you can get this same machine as an Ender 3 with the extra board and the plate for $199, so just under $200. And then you have the silent drivers. It's just so great to have those silent drivers. That's why I think this is such a great value. Now you may say, what about shipping from China? Well, you don't have to. They have a US warehouse. I've bought from their US warehouse and I've gotten it to Michigan in 3 days. And it's free shipping at their site if it's over $49. So it's free shipping on this guy. So you definitely save money. Now you'll get people that argue it's still better to get the 32-bit board. But my argument is the TMC drivers. The silent drivers that come on here, you actually get better prints than you do with those drivers that are on the 32-bit board, Ender 3 or Ender 3 Pro. In fact, I've printed several items on this guy right out of the box. Beautiful. I did a vase, and it's smooth as can be. There's no little bumps on it like some of the printers give you. And it's just really good quality. And if you print a benchy, you don't get those tiger stripes on it that those cheap drivers, noisy drivers, give you. The TMC drivers give you a smoother print. So in reality, this guy with the silent drivers, even though it's an 8-bit board, is actually printing better than the 32-bit Creality machines without the silent drivers. So it's not only noisier, it doesn't print as good. So that's why, to me, this is a better value. And then a glass bed, to me, is just a bonus. There is the valid argument that the 32-bit gives you the opportunity to add auto level and other features because 32-bit has more memory than the 8-bit. But without the silent drivers, you're probably going to replace that board on your Ender 3 anyway, just like you would here. So in either case, you're buying another board, a 32-bit, and that way you could go in an SKR or some other brand. Now, you did pay a little bit more for this, but you got a glass bed in it anyway. So for a while, you print it with a silent driver, and then when you're ready to upgrade to a 32-bit with silent drivers, you're in the same boat. So that's why I still say this is a better value. And watch all my videos. All of them will work. The bed level will stop at the adjustment knobs, and the multicolor prints from Cura will work. You don't have to worry about reflashing firmware. I just think it's a great place to start and a great value for someone getting into 3D printing, or if you want a second printer and don't want to deal with all the crap, it's a great printer to add to your collection. And speaking of circuit boards, I use PCBWay for all my projects. PCBWay.com is a great place to get low-cost circuit boards, but you can also get assembly services. You can supply them the parts or give them a bill of material with the parts list. They will track down the parts, solder things together, review it with you during the process, and at the end ship you completely assembled boards. So if you're looking for a manufacturing partner for your electronics designs, check out PCBWay.com. If you like what I'm doing here, maybe check out some of the other videos popping up, and if nothing else, click on that CHEP logo and subscribe. I'll see you next time, right here at Filament Friday.